Near the small sleepy village of Byers Green lies an even smaller and sleepier village known colloquially as Slowly. Pace of life, or what? The answer is not hard to find. Elsewhere, things were moving a little quicker. In the late 1930s, two railway giants, Wressley and Stania, were locked in battle for the world steam locomotive record. Sir Nigel Wressley of the LNER with his A4 Pacifics and Sir William Stania of the LMS with his Duchess class locos of the same Pacific format. As we all know, the winner was Wressley, with Mallard clocking 125.88 miles per hour on the 3rd of July 1938 at Stoke Bank, just south of Brampton. Six of the Imperious A4s still survive, and in 2014 they were gathered together for probably the last time, an event celebrated as the Great Goodbye, held successively at the National Railway Museum at York and at the Locomotion Museum at Childon. At Childon, 130,000 visitors paid their respects. Mallard was chosen for the record attempt because she was the latest to be built and nicely run in. She was also the first to incorporate the Kiltshaft double chimney multiple blast pipe design, which was later introduced to all the 35 A4s built, before and following. The six engines made an awe-inspiring spectacle, and the old and young from this hotbed of locomotive construction must have felt a lump in the throat. If the spirit of Shildon's own locomotive engineering giant, Timothy Hackworth, was looking down, he must have been well pleased, particularly with the state of development of his original blast pipe design. These locomotives weighed about 200 tons and pulled 400 tons of carriages and developed up to 2,400 drawbar horsepower. Awesome beasts, carrying 4 tons of coal and 5,000 gallons of water. All the A4s between 1935 and 1938 were originally intended to be named after birds, except for two, built for the run between the woolen towns of Leeds and Bradford and London, which were to be given names associated with wool manufacturing. One of them, Golden Shuttle, was renamed Dwight D. Eisenhower in 1945. It's an outstanding testament to their original designs that three A4s are still approved for mainline use. Bitten, Union of South Africa, and perhaps appropriately, Sir Nigel Wressley. We may never see the like again.